We truly work full steam ahead to thrive within this bubble. No crew to lurk midst dreams in bed, the skiving's in less trouble. Some snoozy slop would land the sack, unfit to ply this craft. This bruising job demands a stack of grit allied with graft. If square success inside this sphere forms the stuff you crave, prepare for stress astride each year, storm so tough to brave. One's dream to meet a comely wife can no way be embraced. That scheme for sweet and homely life by rolling seas displaced. Don't wind up dashing out to twirl in thrilled entwining dance, aligned with smashing stout young girl to build a fine romance. This thrusting life of luck is taken on through bold decision. A busty wife to hook, forsaken none to hold in vision. It's true that one I Dave before served time, a married man. This union quite grave was also primed for Harriet Stan. But through rare duties mapped ahead, each then grew just disenchanted. With two bare beauties wrapped in bed, both men from misery planted. I've not thus yet been required to make that heated choice. No hot lust keenly fired, set with ache for sweetheart's voice. I've scarcely sought a spouse in white to thrill and madly cherish. Prepared to court this house of light until I sadly perish. That's not to say some saucy lass won't row through sea to call. Though hot rough days of course will pass with no such treats at all. Such beauty, though sublime, is rare for keen storm-fighting brothers. In duty so much time to bear between one sight and others. Let me now tell about the stay of Stansfeld's sister Rita. For see this bell set out one day, each man dealt bliss to greet her. Such visits by this fruity sex, though sought indeed were few. And this is why acute effects were brought at speed on crew. I noticed Dave then Terry grow a lot less rashly rude. Each doting brave though merry, flowing not so brashly crude. Those two cut out their swearing, peachy mist to touch the band. And grew devoutly caring each to kiss then clutch her hand. Though Terry thought it smart yet cool in crest shirt and tie, he'd very shortly start to drool when this princess skirted by. No strolling fair seemed sweeter, lustful craver, drawn to giggle. His soul in care of Rita, just like Dave to fawn then wriggle. I pushed with real wrenching drive each heat lashed hour long, where fair flush to feel tension drive with Rita's power strong. The slightest flick of golden hair, sweet blue eyes urged to flutter, would light up thickly smouldered stares from two guys merged in mutter. The dazzled pumped up working, there's no man to rank theirs equal. So as he plumped to shirk affairs, began a dank grave sequel. With zest for duties drifting, push from Terry, teed a dive. Those breaths of beauty swift to crush, that very need to strive. Men daft and merry, strove to woo, in reach for strings apart. Then crafty Terry, drove right through, his speech on rings too smart. Those other four were quite agreed, this lad was thirsting trouble. Each brother swore with biting speed, we had to burst his bubble. Stand very soundly, told his sister, wave, prepare, then go. But Terry, bounding, boldly kissed her, Dave declaring, no! We could not sway for their own sakes, though viewed a bit too cruel. For should she stay, it fair would break each prudent written rule. Though worn through duty, trapped in pain, they must, we guessed, recover. They borne that beauty, strapped to brain, in lust to rest a lover. But courting strife could not be wise, just like you read before. This sported life is too hot for guys to spike through wedded law. We viewed it best to instigate a purge of bubbles yearning. Such cruel ingested din created turgid trouble churning. We pushed to send her back to land, desire falling fast. Though rush descend now lacking, and the die was all but cast. Soon Terry sniffled sighs with Dave, defeat so deft by brothers. Two very stiff goodbyes were waved when Rita left for mothers. Stan roared through mist and pouring rain with great determination, and then showed his sis towards the train awaiting her in station. There came to see a letter Rita posted stamped with sorrow, Stan claiming he had better meet her coast a tramp the morrow. I met a fortnight's net at stretch in sliding land she'd trained, and yet one fraught unsettled wretch inside the band still waned.
though very low at first, now Dave has hitched his mind to duty. Yet Terry, though he nursed him, rarely itched to find his lost beauty. He made his plea to scud along when Stan set fly next day. Afraid to see this could be wrong, that man said aye, okay. Next morrow morning Stan returned, so very sad and glum. Vexed, sorrow-born, as plan discerned that Terry had not come. Instead, his sparking brother strolled with Rita, now engaged. He said they'd spark each other's soul, no heat had roused enraged. This naughty gent's romantic drive had placed us in a fix. In short, it meant this frantic five must face the din of six. He left his house and ruby tray to hitch a wife on shore. Bereft, his mouse would struggle fade, and twitch in life no more.